Hi everybody, Jill here. Welcome to my channel. Today we're doing a color comparison with the light blonde in the Tony Bratton line. We're going to be comparing it to a couple blondes in Jean Renault, a blonde in Belle Tresse, and a blonde in the Racco Welch line. I've had a lot of requests for this, so I hope that you guys find this really helpful. I have Trendsetter. This is Tony Bratton in the color light blonde. Now, I'm also going to be comparing, there's a little variation sometimes in, I've noticed, the styles themselves within the Tony Bratton line in their light blonde. One is a little beigier blonde, and then this one here is, it is beige. It is a beigey, ashy sort of blonde. But I'm going to show you in a little bit how it can look even a little more beigey in certain styles. So that's just what I have found so far. I like both of them though. I like both of the sort of, you know, takes on the light blonde in this line. My only guess would be perhaps certain styles may be coming from a different manufacturer. And their colors just a little different within the light blonde. Not sure there, but I'm gonna go ahead and compare that as well. Let's, however, without further ado, compare this color with Shaded Biscuit in the Racco Welch line. All right, here we have Flirt Alert in Shaded Biscuit. Let's take a look at this. Now, this is an absolutely gorgeous color. It really, really is. It is definitely more on the ashy side. It's not like a platinum and it's not a silvery color, but it is definitely a beautiful, light, more ashy blonde. So let's take a look here. This, I believe, they definitely share the lightest of highlights. I think that's, you know, they're pretty close with their lightest color there. And then we have a definitely the back base that I'm seeing here in Shaded Biscuit. I am also seeing that. I wanna say there is some, not quite as dark as what you would see in the root here, but I am seeing this sort of lighter color, but it's a little darker, and I'm kind of seeing that kind of right in there as well. We have a darker root here in Shaded Biscuit, but the root color in this one definitely is not the same color. This is quite a bit darker. Definitely quite a bit darker here. This is not quite so dark, and it's also a definitely more of a beigey color here, if you can kind of see. We'll see how accurate this is when I'm editing. I'm hoping that you're seeing the true sort of colors and hues and tones. So I think because this root color is, what would that be, the 12, is, gives the all over look kind of more of a softer blend, a softer look here in Shaded Biscuit. Whereas this, and I don't know the color codes in these. I'm not sure, I don't think they give you the color codes. But this is quite a dark root. And I know some of you said, I wish that root wasn't quite so dark. I actually really like it. It doesn't bother me as long as I pay attention to my eyebrows, make sure my eyebrows are a little darker than maybe I would normally wear of something like this. But all over the Shaded Biscuit, definitely this root and all of that, it's just, it's a little bit of a softer transition than we have here. This is very nicely done though. It's not like it's grown out to here. So I'm going to go ahead and grab another wig in light blonde that's maybe a little more closer to this length. These are both heat-friendly fibers. I made sure that I chose heat-friendly fibers in my comparison. All right, this may be a little better now. So this is the light blonde, and this is the shaded biscuit. Well, they're both gorgeous. I would say the shaded biscuit definitely is lighter, and there's more of that lighter color in the highlights in, I think, shaded biscuit overall. So I think in general it does. Oh my gosh, you guys, they are so close. They really are. At least the light blonde here in the wig, adorable. they are very close. This one is a little beigier, more beige, even than shaded biscuit here. But their back colors, their sort of low lights, are very close to the same. But then when we get to the front, you know, Raquel Welch does get quite a bit lighter there in the very front. But yeah, that's quite close, because even the adorable gets a little lighter in the front as well. So I hope that gives you sort of an idea there. However, let's look at the adorable next step. That they're definitely pretty close here. This, yeah. But I want to show you Timeless, which is one of the wigs that I just reviewed. Here it is right here. This one is so much more beigey than the light blonde. And this was light blonde as well. But look at the difference. Look at how much more beige this is. Completely very different, but it is very pretty. But it is different. It is not the same light blonde as what's in the Trendsetter. And then if we were to look at the beige version and hold it up against shaded biscuit here, even though it's kind of hard, it is significantly more beige, you know, compared to, you know, the shaded biscuit. I know it's hard because this is so much shorter than the shaded biscuit. So this is what I've noticed. Let's look at the Timeless in the Toni Braten light blonde with the adorable that I just compared very close to shaded biscuit. And you can see, while it, you know, there are obviously similar colors, I am just seeing sort of more beige than I'm seeing in this one. All right, so these two, here's their root colors. Now, this is the adorable Toni Braten. This is the, I mean, yeah, and then this is the shaded biscuit. So let's kind of look at those rooted colors, the rooting there. They're actually very close, very close. Yeah. So shaded biscuit, light blonde. Let's look in the front. I mean, if you're looking, You know, if you're looking for something around this color, you know, I think this would be good. Unless, you know, you get something like Timeless, where it is definitely more beigey. Again, I have to wonder, different manufacturer, not sure. Okay, so let's now take a look at Palm Springs Blonde. So here is Ignite in Palm Springs Blonde. Let's just take a look at Ignite here. Beautiful color, my lord. It is so pretty. And then we have the Trendsetter in the Light Blonde. You know, we've got that really soft, soft brooding in Palm Springs Blonde. So we definitely aren't close there. Again, definitely beigier. So let's take a look at this next to Timeless. So we can see for sure how much lighter Palm Springs Blonde is compared here. It's just no comparison, really. Very different. Very, very, very different, these two. So, again, this is Light Blonde. And then, you know, we have Shaded Biscuit and Palm Springs Blonde. And this one is lighter. Then let's look at this and the Adorable in the Toni Braten line in Light Blonde once again. So we got Ignite, Palm Springs Blonde, and Light Blonde in the Toni Braten line. All right, now I want to take a look at Malibu Blonde in the Jean Renault. It's definitely a little gold, you know, there's some pretty light gold in there. So let me get, this is the Light Blonde Toni Braten's Adorable wig and the Malibu Blonde. So right away, the Malibu Blonde definitely is more gold, more, it's definitely warm. I think that's pretty evident. So, Malibu Blonde, if you like more of a warm, that would be Malibu Blonde. This is definitely more ashy, more beigey, even though it's not the beigest, apparently, in that line. But definitely cooler. This is cooler, warmer. Both gorgeous. And then again, let's look at the beige version of Light Blonde. Definitely very different. Very, 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 very different. I've got one more that I want to look at, you guys. One more. So here we have honey with chai latte, and this is a Beltress color. The rooting again is quite soft. So let's take a look at the adorable light blonde. Oh no, this is Hope. Actually, while I have these out, let's look at 12. FS12, the Malibu Blonde, compared to the Honey with Chai Latte. So this one looks like it is still yet a little warmer, even. So these are pretty close. Malibu Blonde and Honey with Chai Latte. You know, I think it's just a little bit lighter. Honey with Light Chai Latte just seems to me to be overall just a little lighter all over. All right, so now let's take a look at Adorable by Toni Braten and Honey with Chai Latte. So definitely warmer here, definitely warmer. Softer root for sure. They're rooting. Yeah, so definitely warmer. Both are absolutely gorgeous. Both are really pretty, really pretty, but definitely warmer than this. All right. You can definitely see it when I hold it up to Trendsetter. Even the Adorable looks a little bit more beigey. No, I guess not. Alright guys, so I hope that you found this helpful. I have been dying to do this myself and I just haven't gotten around to do it. So this was really interesting to me too. So I guess I'll let you come to your own conclusions on that. Again, everybody's monitor is a little different, but I sure hope that this, you know, gave you some clarity in comparing some of these blondes in different lines. Alright, thank you so much for tuning in and I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.